points, they seem to just, okay, LeBron, take the ball and start turning the ball over and throwing it up in the air and all this stuff like that. It's just horrible to watch when they get a lead. It's almost like they thrive on having close games and pulling it out, and Dwayne Wade is that exact player. But I think the way that they win is they just keep the way that they're doing. They swarm, they play defense, and they attack the basket. If they attack the basket, if LeBron James, Dwayne Wade is attacking the basket, it's over for Dallas.
How does Dallas win to even up the series?
Dallas wins, they've got to hit shots, and they've got to have their bench step up, and they just, it's plain and simple. They need to stop putting themselves in the hole starting the game. It seems like every time they're playing, they've got to dig themselves out of the hole, and you can't do that throughout a whole game. And it was a miracle what they did in game two, but you could just see a trend. They dig themselves in a hole the whole series, and they got to keep the game close. They can't be down 7, 8, 9, 10 points and keep trying to fight back the whole game, because it's just not going to work. So they got to keep the game close. They got to get some type of lead, but they got to start hitting shots.
Yeah, definitely. That is Patrick Gallagher. Talked a little NBA Finals. Of course, check out the NBA Finals tonight on ABC. Game 4, Miami is up 2-1. Can they go up 3-1, or will the series be even at 2? We're going to take a quick break.
It's over.
And Patrick, if you can stay with us, we're going to talk a little Cardinal baseball as well for just a second or so, and then we're going to get into some wrestling. My man Jason Greer is in the building, and I want to hear what he has to say about last night's Raw, if he did catch it, and what to look forward to seeing at Capital Punishment. So without question, let's go to a break, catch our breath a little bit, and we'll be back with more In The Zone right here on iWatchRadio.com. Now you can see what we're talking about. Stay close, folks.
Thanks for having me, man.
He's here! That's how I do everybody here. Come in. Right, brother, hold on. I've got more than one clone, man. All right. There was another guy that was
in my girlfriend's job, that said he looked like me, so I'm like, I seen him before.
Right.
And it was like, y'all are wrong. So I've got clones everywhere here in St. Louis, I'll find out.
I guess that's what I'm going to look like when I get to Texas.
Right.
I got some panic. kids is playing this. Yes, I got some honey, some chocolate dipping kisses full of love for you. Yes, I got some honey, kids is playing this. Yes, I got some honey, some chocolate dipping kisses full of love for you.
In the Zone right here on iWatchRadio.com. Now you can see what we're talking about. The second half of the program, we're here, and beside me is one of the new hosts here on iWatchRadio.com. He has a brilliant show. It's called what now, Mr. Greer?
Giving You Back to You.
Giving You Back to You, ladies and gentlemen. It's Jason Greer with us.
What's up, folks?
And he's going to talk a little wrestling with us to close out the program for the last 20 minutes. But before we do, I have to talk a little Cardinal baseball. And right now, believe it or not, St. Louis is on a high right now. They just finished off a sweep with Chicago Cubs to the point that even one Carlos Zambrano, Jason, is very furious with his ball club. He decided to apologize to Carlos Marmol, but not the rest of his team. So, and another thing that people are not too happy with is the play of Albert Pujols. Now, the reason why I say the play, he's done an awesome job at the plate.
Right.
But they're not liking the fact of how he's celebrating all his home runs. You know, staring at him, watching it go over the wall, and then his celebration looking like a 5-year-old kid. I say that celebration, I liked it. And they say he doesn't go out and hustle from time to time. So give me your thoughts a little bit on Albert.
See, I think people don't appreciate the fact that Albert's coming. Albert's been in a slump.
Mm-hmm.
For where Albert Pujols was last year compared to where Albert Pujols is this year, it's like night and day. So here's my thing. If that's what it takes in order to get him over the hump, just like he did against the Cubs, do if you need to run around the bases without your shirt on, that's what you do.
Definitely. I mean, I don't have any problem with the celebrations, but there has been times where he's had walk off shots, and then the next day somebody's ready to beam him for right. his actions. And closely, those in San Diego, I remember very fondly. Time when the old Busch Stadium was up, you know, Pujols had that walk-off shot the next day. They hit him, and they didn't care anything about it. So, I mean, just to be on the safe side, he can have his celebratory walk because right. that's what he does. That's what he's been doing since he's been in the league in 01.
Absolutely.
But they say showing up a pitcher is wrong, and it was like the days of Gibson and Don Drysdale. They would have knocked him senseless, made him eat a baseball.
I get it, but it's two different eras.
That's what I'm telling everybody. This is a different era now.
I mean, this belief that, you know, baseball is still a gentleman's game.
That's gone.
The day that free agency changed the entire makeup, you can have a team that goes to the World Series. Look at the Florida Marlins back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
They go to the World Series, they win the World Series, and the following year they don't even make it to the playoffs because their roster is completely gutted.
Right.
Here's the thing about it. I think when Albert Pujols, and it always comes back to that contract, I think when Albert Pujols made his demands for that contract, whatever the numbers were,
mm-hmm.
he put a level of pressure on himself that I don't think he was quite ready for. In addition to the fact that baseball fans, for some reason, have grown incredibly fickle as it relates to anybody who thinks they should make over $100 million. And I think anything and everything Albert Pujols is doing is coming under intense scrutiny, which he wasn't prepared for. It comes with the money.
You got to understand, he was very cheap. At first, when he first got his contract, six years, $100 million, that was a cheap deal that the Cardinals gave him. Mm-hmm. And they wanted to solidify, okay, this is our $100 million man.
Sure.
Now that A-Rod and the Jeters of today are getting $200 million mm-hmm. In tenured contracts, Albert Pujols, I believe one of the greatest players in the game,
without a doubt,
should be able to get himself at least into that category. I mean, Cardinals, I never understand, Jason, is that why baseball owners, mm-hmm. baseball organizations don't give the money that's well-deserved to players. That's why people like to go players like to go to the Yankees. Because they're going to pay their players regardless.
No matter what. No matter what.
Win or lose.
Absolutely.
They're going to get paid, and they're going to get paid well.
Right.
And there's, like you said, about free agency and the fact that there's no salary cap.
See, that's it right there.
There's no salary cap right. in baseball. Football is starting to lift that now, and I believe it's going to hurt the game even more. But baseball was meant for no salary cap. I can't see unless you want to see other teams win.
Right.
But that won't ever happen.
Here's the thing about Albert Pujols. The Cardinals fans, and I love Cardinals fans, I'm a diehard Cardinals fan. I mean, I love the Cardinals, without a doubt. But we can't continue to look at a guy like Albert Pujols and say, show us your loyalty, right? Stay in St. Louis. We'll do anything in the world for you. Just accept a little bit less or a whole lot less than what these other guys are getting paid. Albert Pujols, how old is he?
He's 31. He's 31 now.
He's already looking at the downside of his career. If he's going to make his money, he's got to make his money now.
Mm-hmm.
Loyalty carries you far, but folks, come on. This isn't the day of Bob Gibson.
Right. The loyalty is gone in sports, period.
Let's consider Ozzie Smith.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the way Ozzie Smith went out.
It wasn't bad note. Very bad note.
Yeah. It wasn't exactly the most gracious exit. He felt like he wasn't treated the way he should have been for a player of his caliber.
Exactly. So, I mean, Albert is by far one of the greatest players, greatest hitters of our time. I mean, if he happens to go into steroids, you know what? As much as I would say I would be so shocked, I can't be, because that's the juice era we're in today.
Right.
And as much as Albert has been very spiritual about everything, he is the most humbling athlete I've ever seen.
It's incredible.
I mean, I can't understand why he is considered one of the top athletes, you know, that are very humble. He's not brash about his thing. Now, he may do it at the plate, but that's in his forte.
Absolutely.
Off the field, he is not the same guy. So, it's like, is he having two different personalities? No. It's the same thing how Michael Jordan was, but, you know, different now off the court.
Right.
He can be a little brash off the court, especially now.
Absolutely.
But there are few athletes today that don't have that humbling character such as Albert Pujols.
Right. And something else to consider, we don't know the relationship between the hitter and the pitcher. That's another thing. Albert Pujols, I've always felt like this. He's a competitor.
Mm-hmm.
He's always been very good about managing his persona, his public persona, making sure that whatever happens behind closed doors never gets out to the public. Mm-hmm. I get that. But you've got a guy who's struggling to come out of whatever mental fog he's going through,
mm-hmm.
whatever personal fog he's going through. It's just the nature of the game.
All right, hit that music for me, because we're about to move to a little rest. And don't forget to catch the Cardinals and Astros tonight on Fox Sports Midwest. I believe that's 6:05 today. Hit that rest of music. I'm going to throw this out there today.
Not Cena. You're killing me. You're killing
me. Yes, that's the only reason why I did it, because I know you hate him.
Not Cena.
You hate him.
Not Cena. Don't give me this.
It's time for our Wrestling Week Talk, of course, with Mr. Greer. And folks, if you didn't see Raw last night, it was one that it was a head scratcher.
I feel
it was a very, very, very big head scratcher. One, don't get me wrong, the tough enough winner. Did it shock you that Andy won?
Not at all. I'll tell you why. Vince McMahon, with all due respect to Stone Cold Steve Austin, who I feel like is one of the greatest superstars of all time, even though he says he's the one calling the shots, Vince McMahon's calling the shots.
Exactly. And Triple H are calling the shots.
Triple H. The WWE is all about the big money. You got a guy like Andy. I mean, look at where Andy was in the recap show. Andy had to put on a good 15 pounds of muscle.
Mm-hmm.
So it already shows that his frame, he's capable of expanding. He's got size. He's got a look. Charisma. Not really
there. It's starting to come together, because what I saw last night, especially for the final and going into the finale of Tough Enough, going into Raw.
Right.
I'm starting to see a little bit of his charisma, and I saw a little Edge, and I saw a little Undertaker in him.
I feel you.
I saw that, and with Luke, don't think that he's gone for good.
Luka
will be there.
They're going to pick up Luka.